How should you brake in a new motorbike engine? There's a fair bit of fact and fiction about the best procedures, mixed in with plenty of hearsay and anecdotal evidence. In the old days, manufacturers said, baby the engine for the first gazillion miles or so. Some guys still follow this, even though it no longer applies. Other riders say, ride the bike like you stole it. And then there's the middle road, just ride the bike like you usually do. And a spoiler alert, that is our position. We will explain why shortly. Probably the most important point is just don't get hung up on how you brake in your new engine. Chances are it won't make a big difference anyway. So we did a pile of research, then chatted with our two very experienced mechanics. Our conclusion? New bikes have already been tested and run at the factory, and the rest of the break-in period done by you is very short. Just warm the engine up briefly, don't let it idle for minutes, vary the revs from low to high in the break-in period, put the engine under load, but don't baby it. Flogging it really hard probably won't hurt, but it probably won't help either. And replace the engine oil after the first hour or as per the manufacturer's recommendations. So that sums it up, but if you are bored, feel free to hang around as we look into the scant research around and get into some more detail. The parts in your new engine might look smooth and shiny, but they're very rough at the microscopic level. A typical motorbike engine makes all those rough surfaces smooth over about 3.5 hours. And most of that wear occurs in the first hour. That's why it's often important to replace your engine oil after the first ride with a high performance bike, or at least follow manufacturer's recommendations. Typically, your oil will become filled with tiny bits of metal that could cause premature wear in the long run. Sometimes too, manufacturers have a different weight of oil for the break-in period. Manufacturers usually take care of the very first break-in steps at the factory with what is called a dead run. This, combined with all the modern technology, means your break-in period is reduced to somewhere around the 1 to 3 hour mark. Typically, it's holding the bike at maximum power for up to a minute. So, let's look at the theories. Methods of braking in your engine can be broken into four main categories: the gentle break-in, the aggressive break-in, the moderate break-in, and heat cycles. The gentle break-in is the old school approach, such as don't go over half throttle for the first 1,000 kilometres. Many riders still do this because it's the way their daddy did it and the way their grandpappy did it. It no longer applies due to modern engine design and the anti-wear compounds in modern oils. And if you go too easy on the engine, there is the small risk of glazing your rings and not getting a good seat with the bore, which can mean marginally less power, higher fuel consumption, and burning oil. Not a good idea. The aggressive break-in, very popular school of thought, ride the bike like you stole it immediately after the first warm-up, using full throttle as much as possible. With luck, you will get a good ring seal with the bore, but our experts say it's not necessarily good news for any plain-wearing surfaces and the piston skirt. The moderate break-in, the one we favour, it aims to cause wear and pressure where it's needed, but avoid excessive wear where you don't want it. It assumes you need a moderate degree of load on the engine to properly bed your rings in with the bore. There's very little research done in the whole area of braking in engines, but industry reports tend to back this approach consistently. And finally, heat cycling. Some claim it's important to go through several heat cycles in order to toughen the metal of various parts. Methods vary. Here is a typical one. The weird thing is, I cannot find any research or evidence to back this up. Manufacturers don't recommend it, and key engine parts are heat treated before assembly at much higher temperatures than the engine will run at. So I suspect it's a myth. And while we are talking about potential myths, another one is not using synthetic oil during break-in. I cannot find anything to back this up, but pause to read this if you are interested. Finally, is how you brake in your motorbike engine really that important? Well, the fact is, no matter what approach you take, the current engine oils are so good, your engine will probably perform well and last a long time, almost no matter what you do. And this is why most riders feel that their brake-in procedure is the right one, because they didn't hit any problems. But it certainly makes sense to brake in your engine well, as it could mean getting a few more hours before that rebuild is needed. So follow the manufacturer's advice if you want. We think the moderate brake-in procedure for the first hour to 3 hours is the way to go, along with this pile of handy tips. Very keen to know your own experiences, and if you've come across any research that might help, we would love to hear that too. Cheers, guys.